There are no superfoods to shrink an enlarged prostate. In this video, I will explain to you the sobering truth about foods and supplements which allegedly shrink your prostate. But that doesn't mean that there isn't anything that could be done about it. Later in this video, I will explain to you why visiting a urologist is a smart move. My name is Stefan Buntrock and I am a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Urology is the medical specialty that owns the prostate and the urinary tract. There is an abundance of false and misleading information on YouTube concerning benign prostatic enlargement. First of all, benign prostatic enlargement is not a swelling. The prostate is a gland that enlarges because of real growth. There is no such thing as a super nut or miracle drink that could change that. There are only three methods to reduce the size of an enlarged prostate. Number one is reduce it surgically by laser, water beam, steam, conventional sling, whatever. Number two is cut it off from its blood supply. This would be a radiologic intervention that involves selectively closing crucial arteries. Number three is eliminate testosterone. Blocking testosterone will result in a 20 to 30% reduction in size and is the least effective of these methods. Finasteride or Dutasteride are the typical drugs for that. Of course, castration will also make the prostate smaller. However, the most important question is, why would you want to shrink your prostate in the first place? I would guess it's because of bothersome symptoms with frequency, urgency, weak stream, incomplete bladder emptying, urination at night. Here's the news. These symptoms may be, but are not necessarily linked to an enlarged prostate. There are a lot of different conditions which cause these symptoms other than an enlarged prostate. Here are some examples. Bladder infection, neurogenic causes, diabetes, bladder cancer, prostate cancer, polyuria, overactive bladder. If the prostate is responsible for bothersome symptoms, it is often because of an unfavorable configuration. You know, prostates come in different shapes and sizes. If the middle part of the gland is enlarged and bulges into the bladder neck, this is often associated with lower urinary tract symptoms. I have a lot of patients where I find enlarged prostates at checkup, but only a fraction of them are bothered by symptoms. If you have problems yourself, you should make an appointment with your local urologist. Ultrasound measurements will be able to confirm that your prostate is enlarged. Urinalysis, pressure flow studies, measurement of the residual urine, lab tests, and a physical examination will be able to come to the correct diagnosis. One doesn't always have to operate or prescribe medication. In mild cases, lifestyle modifications may be enough, such as a smart management of your fluid intake. Nutrition is an integral ingredient of a healthy lifestyle. It is beneficial and important to eat healthy. A healthy diet may help you to prevent the prostate from enlarging, but it is not a cure for prostate enlargement. Once the damage is done, food will not be able to make it smaller again. I have uploaded several videos on what to eat. Nutrition is not about single foods, it's about food patterns. One has to understand that. If your main food is burgers, pizza, and a Coke, the occasional tomato or walnut will not make much of a difference. Superfoods will only make a difference when embedded into a healthy diet. If you want to know how to do that, here's a playlist. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.